Today we are interviewing Joy Hughes, a bus driver, and he's going to tell us all about what he does driving a bus and what his duties are. But the reason he's here is because he had an episode with a coyote here in Leisure World. So first of all, we're going to ask him, Joy, what kind of bus do you drive around Leisure World here?
I drive one of the white shuttle buses. It's a Seal Beach senior bus. And we take people shopping down to the shopping area, to Target and Rouse. And that's pretty much it. And to the senior lunch in the morning.
So what's the senior lunch in the morning? What's that about?
Well, we have two trips that go down to the community center, which is on St. Cloud, right off of Seal Beach Boulevard. And we have lunch there Monday through Friday. It's like $3. You can get a nice lunch. And that's about that.
Okay, how much does it cost to get the bus ride to go to be picked up at your apartment and taken to the lunch place?
It's free.
Oh, okay. So it's free of charge. So all they have to do is call a certain number.
Yes.
Okay, and we'll announce that number later.
Okay.
Okay, unless you know it.
I know.
Okay, what is it?
That number is 562-439.
There, one more time again.
562-439.
Okay, and that's the one that gets you into the system. You still have to pay for lunch, but you get a free ride to and from lunch,
yes,
right?
Yes, get a free ride to and from lunch, to as close to your door as possible.
And what if I had a wheelchair? Can I still take that service?
Yes, we take wheelchairs.
And walkers and any mobility challenged people?
Yes, and walkers.
Okay. Okay, now, when you were doing your bus route, what happened that you encountered a coyote incident?
Well, I parked my bus right on Knollwood, and I was a little early to work, so I just went out for a little quick walk for about 5 minutes before I started my route, and then I heard a dog barking as I was going back to the bus. And then the barking turned into really loud yelping, so I stopped and I thought to myself, I wonder if that's a coyote that I've been hearing all about. And then as I was stopped thinking about that, I started to hear a woman screaming saying, "Get out of here, get out of here." So I immediately went running back to where I heard the yelling come, where it was coming from, and I came around the building following the lady's voice, and I said to myself, "Don't let me see a coyote eating a dog here." And sure enough, I saw a coyote running off with this lady's dog, so I just kept running, and thinking I could maybe scream and clap my hands to scare the coyote into letting the dog go. And so I was chasing the coyote across the yard over there by it's very close to, it's Oakmont and El Dorado. And so I was chasing after the coyote as he had the dog in his mouth. It's a 15-pound Shih Tzu, little cute white dog. And so the dog was squirming out of the coyote's mouth, kind of, so the coyote would stop to get a better grip on the dog's neck. And every time he did that, he would violently shake the dog, you know, by his neck, trying to, you know, kill the dog, I guess, to make it easier to run off with him. So every time the coyote would stop to get a better grip on the dog, I would catch up with him more and more until I found myself like face to face with him, with his back against the wall of one of the condominium buildings. And so that's when I realized this is a a wild coyote, so I better, like, you know, what do I do now? So I just continued to scream and yell and clap my hands in the coyote's face. And then after, but even when I did that, he didn't let go right away. He kept chewing on the dog. And then I just did it a couple more times, and then he let go and he just walked away, like, very casual. And then the little dog, who me and I and the owner thought the dog was dead at this point, because he had shook him and chewed on him every time that he would stop to get a better grip on him. So, but when he, but when the coyote let go of the dog and walked away, the little dog was just fine, and he ran after the coyote and he tried to get the coyote. So, that's when I threw my hands in the air and I said, uh-oh, well, what am I going to do now? So then the coyote took off, and I just wanted to make sure he was going to, I tried to make the coyote feel threatened to not come back to this area, so I just kind of chased after him and followed him until I couldn't see him anymore. And then after that, I went back, I met the owner of the dog, and found out that her dog actually went chasing after the coyote in the first place, so she had accidentally left the door open, and she thanked me for, you know, scaring the coyote. And then that was about it, I think. But yeah, it was kind of funny. When I was chasing the coyote, I was screaming and clapping my hands as loud as I could, running through Leisure World. So
did the dog ever come back, or did you get the dog?
Oh, the dog did. What he was doing was he was chasing the coyote, like, because the coyote was running in the direction of the dog's house. So he followed him, barking at the back of his legs and getting really close to him, just long enough until he made it around the corner of his building. Then he went straight home. That's when I stopped and I looked. I saw that he was safe. He was inside the house, because I didn't want the coyote just to turn back around and get the dog again. So I made sure the dog went in the house. And then I thought, what do I do? And then I said, well, let's just maybe try to scare him out of this area. So I saw the coyote take a left and turn around a building up ahead of me. So I ran after him. I followed him. And because I had stopped to watch the dog going back into his house, I think he got a head start. The coyote got a head start, and so it was hard for me to catch up with him. I went around the building, and then sure enough, I saw all these people standing outside pointing in the direction, obviously, of the coyote. So I asked them all, I said, as I was running by, I asked them, which way did he go? And they all pointed out, well, he went up here. And he took a left at the corner. And so I ran up there and I go, oh no. I took a left at the corner and I go, he just ran back to the house where the dog lives. So I said, man, I shouldn't have left the dog over there, but I should have left the area. But by then, in front of the dog's house, there was a crowd of people. So I think they had scared the coyote from going back there. And So, yeah, then that's when I ran back there and I asked them, I said, hey, did the coyote come back by here? And they said, yeah, the coyote was here. I said, do you mean the coyote was here when I was chasing him through here? Or did he come back here a second time? And they said, oh, he came by here one time with you. So I said, okay, then we're probably okay now.
Okay, so thanks to you, you saved a dog from being carried away by a coyote.
Maybe, yeah, I hope so. Because I kind of ran for a while.
Well, thank you very much, Joy Hughes.
Sure. Okay.